Blessing. Blessing. The sticker prince said blessing. It is a call. You shall not make. When she wants to pray, she goes to kneel down before the pastor sticker to pray. Who says that? Pastors don't have any power. Power belongs to Jesus. Will you not say amen? No pastor. No pastor. Any pastor who boasts that he has power, he's using a witchcraft. He's a suspect. Any pastor who says, if you don't put this my water with my sticker on it, you will not give birth. He's a wizard. You shall not make for yourself a calf image, including the status of Virgin Mary. It's a goddess. The Bible means what it says and says what it means. Don't bow to them. Don't worship them. Commandment number 3. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain. Listen. You come to church in the day, in the night, you seek an insurance policy with an occultic group. A friend of mine died yesterday. He died. He went for occultic money, blood money. He died. He claimed he's a Christian. He went to take money. 2 months, he bought the best cars in the village. The best houses in the village. He died yesterday. The mother said they should call me. He took his younger brother also there. He came to give fat offering in church. And the pastor said he's the best giver in church. We pastors, we have made peace become gods in church. You shall not take the name of the Lord your God in vain means don't say you are a Christian. You preach virtue. And you practice vices. A Christian doesn't lie. If you lie and you claim still you are a Christian, you are taking God for granted. A Christian doesn't fornicate. If you fornicate and you still claim you are a Christian, you are taking God for granted. A Christian doesn't commit adultery. If you commit adultery and you claim you are a Christian, you are taking the name of God in vain. It's not a suggestion, Nigeria. It is a command. You shall not take the name of the Lord, your God, the one who created you. How can you take his name in vain? Some of us, when we are even in the washroom, because we don't take fruits, we don't take fruits. When it is time to visit the loo, we can't defecate. Then we say, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Go and buy mango and banana and stop calling the name of God in vain. Will you say amen there? Amen. Some of the ladies, they are not afraid of things they need to be afraid of. When they see a cockroach, Jesus. When they see a lizard, Jesus. The day you will call him, he will not respond. Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord in vain. Will you not say amen there? Law 4. Remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of the Lord your God. I will come back to this tomorrow. Commandment number 5. Honor your father and your mother. Commandment number 6. You shall not murder. Commandment number 7. You shall not commit adultery. Commandment number 8. You shall not steal. I wish Nigeria can hear me. I have a sermon I title, The Day I'll Speak to the Nation. Nigeria should not experience light off in 2016. Why? 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 You shall not steal. This rich nation, we refuse to preach the Ten Commandments. So church members who claim to be over 50% of the population of Nigeria, everybody wants to get rich and the country is suffering. You shall not steal. Not even when you are dying should you not steal to live. Commandment number 9. You shall not bear false witness against your neighbor. Don't lie against a friend, against a brother. Commandment number 10. You shall not envy or covet your neighbor's house. You shall not covet your neighbor's wife, nor his male servant, nor his female servant, nor his ox, nor his donkey, nor anything that is your neighbor's. These 10 commandments, they are not suggestions. I want to ask, if you believe we must keep all these 10 commandments, let me see your hand. Hands down. If you don't believe that they must not be kept, let me see your hand. I met a customs officer in Ghana. We're having a Bible study. And he said, Pastor, we can't keep the 10 commandments. It is not to be kept. I said, no problem. That's the deal. I have an offer tonight. Can you give me your wife for 2 nights? He's a foolish man. I said, which foolish man? Which law prohibits, if not the 10 commandments, that I should not touch your wife? If the 10 commandments is not reasonable, get me your wife. I said, 2 nights, she'll get twins. That's a commercial break. How can you want a lawful society without the 10 commandments? Ladies and gentlemen, unveiling the Siamese twins in the Bible. As the people of Israel listened, they were greatly moved. If that was God's will, they were determined to do it. They said, if God said it, I would do it. How many people here want to do God's will? God's will. God's will. God's will. I can't see them. God's will. God's will. Can you give him a round of applause? Just a round of applause. Wow. God's will. How many people here believe we must not keep all the 10 commandments? We must keep only 9 and leave 1. Let me see your hand. Excellent. Listen, the 10 commandments is so critical to God. He didn't give it to any prophets to write. He never gave it to any apostle. He never gave it to any seer. He never gave it to any disciple. He wrote it himself. Exodus 31, verse 18. Can you join me as we read together? It says what? When the Lord finished speaking to Moses on Mount Sinai, what did he say? It continued that he gave him what? Of testimony. What else did he say? The tablet of stone inscribed by the finger of who? God. Who wrote the 10 commandments? I didn't hear that. Who wrote the 10 commandments? Because God wrote it. That is why the Bible says in Psalm 19, verse 7, the law of the Lord is perfect. Will you not say an amen there? Amen. Anybody who tells you that the 10 commandments is not perfect, he is ignorant of what the Bible says. And the Bible means what it says. It says the law is perfect. My brothers and sisters, unveiling the Siamese twins in the Bible. Our world became rebellious. Our world stood against God. Even before God gave the 10 commandments on Mount Sinai, to break this law was a sin. How do I know? Romans 4, 15. Where there is no law, there is no word, transgression. In 1 John 3 verse 4, sin is the transgression or is the breaking of the law. So you ask the question. The question then is asked, did Cain sin by killing Abel? Did he sin? Did Cain sin by killing his brother Abel? Did he sin? How do we know he broke the law? Which of the law? thou shalt not kill. Before God gave the law on Mount Sinai, the law has always been in existence. Because the Bible says, some say the law, the Ten Commandments, was meant for the children of Israel. No! Genesis 26 verse 5. Because Abraham obeyed my voice and kept my charge, my commandments, my status, and my word. Abraham gave birth to Isaac. Isaac gave birth to Jacob and Esau. Jacob gave birth to 12 boys. One of them was Judah. It was Abraham's grandson, Jacob. They used to name Israel. So Abraham lived before the children of Israel existed. Even before they gave the law, in the days of Moses, Abraham was keeping the law. There was a man, he's not a typical Nigerian. The wife of the president said, sleep with me. His name, Joseph. He's not like a Nigerian man who, when a lady even winked the eye to, they want to jump at her. The woman said, I've given you scholarship, 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 scholarship. Sleep with me. Listen to what he said. Genesis 39, verse 9. My master has withheld nothing from me except you, because you are his wife. How then could I do such a wicked thing and sin against who? I didn't hear that. And sin against who? In this statement, when we sin, we offend two people. Number one, he says his master. Number two, God. I will explain later. Some say when Jesus came, he came to do away with the law. Is that what the Bible teaches? Matthew 5, 17, 18. He said, do not think. Jesus said, let it not even cross your mind that I came to destroy the law or the prophet. I did not come to destroy, but to fulfill. And he continued to say, for assuredly I say, till heaven and earth pass away, not one jot or one little will by no means pass from the law until all is fulfilled. Did Jesus cancel the law? Did Jesus cancel the law? Did Jesus cancel the law? Maybe you don't understand. Let me read another one. Luke 16, verse 17. It is easier for heaven and earth to disappear than for the least stroke of the pen drop out of the law. Is there a heaven? Do we still have heaven? Are we still having earth? Jesus says, if there is heaven, if there is earth, my law, not even an alphabet, will be out of it. Some say, when Jesus died, it's now okay to commit adultery. It's now okay to steal. Because they claim that the death of Jesus has nailed the law. How? And they quote this text, Ephesians 2, verse 15. Having abolished in his flesh the enmity, that is the law of commandment contained in ordinances. The only law contained in ordinances, as I show you, the moral and the ceremonial, was the ceremonial law. The Ten Commandments was not in ordinances. It was in the law. It was in the ark. The ceremonial law came to an end the day Jesus died. That's why when Jesus was on the cross, it was around 3 to 4 o'clock. They wanted to go and sacrifice. And when he said it is finished, the priest was about to sacrifice that Friday. The lamb jumped, and ran away. The veil was divided. That is why today, when we sin, we don't bring a lamb. We don't bring a dove. We go on our knees and ask God, forgive us. The ceremonial law is off. That is why Jesus told this lady, neither do I condemn thee. Go and sin no more. If you are weak in keeping the law, don't say the law is not there. It is you who must not be there. But the grace of God can help us. If you are weak, 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9 says, my grace is sufficient for you, for my strength is made perfect in your weakness. Jesus leads us to obedience. Jesus leads us to keep the law. Jesus leads us to be faithful to the law. Jesus gives us power to keep the law. Jesus never leads us to disobedience. He leads us to obedience. Will you not shout an amen there? Amen. If you love Jesus, let me see your hand. Hands down. If you love Satan, let me see your hand. If you love Jesus, give a round of applause. Let me see. Your clapping doesn't show you love Jesus. For 1 year, it doesn't show you love Jesus. Watch this. What shows you love Jesus? John 14, 15, he says what? I didn't hear that. He says what? It's not clapping. It's not speaking in tongues. It's not prayer. It's not rolling on the ground. If you love me, keep my commandment. Is there somebody here who wants to keep the commandment? Let me see your hand. Now, those who are willing to keep the commandment, give Jesus a round of applause. Let me see now. All right. Shout a big amen there. I didn't hear you. Shout a big amen there. Now, wait a minute. This is the meaning. If you are here, you don't believe that you need to keep the commandment, can you shout an amen? Let's read this together. 1 John 5, 3. It says what? This is love for who? No. This is love for who? What shows you love God? Continue. It says what? To obey what? To obey what? His commands. And his commands are not burdensome. In other words, anybody who says the 10th commandment is difficult to keep, the person is a liar. The Bible says the commandment of God, they are easy. Why do you want to sleep with somebody's wife and you say it is difficult, that you cannot control yourself, you want to sleep with the person's wife? You've not married a lady, you want to sleep with her. Then he said it is difficult not to sleep with her. You must be crazy. This Bible is not for you. You want to steal it and go and read it in church. Why? Then he said, it is difficult. It is difficult not to steal it. Your friend never said what you are saying. You said it is difficult not to say it that way. You want to say what he did not say. Saying what he said is difficult. What kind of thinking is this? This is love for God. Not to speak in tongues. Not to roll on the ground. Not to do miracles. Not to do signs and wonders. This is love for God. To obey his commands. And his commands are not burdensome. Somebody says, Pastor, Jesus teaches that all we need is love. Love, 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 love. Everywhere. Musicians, I'm watching some of your musicians. Everything is about love and naked women. And guess what? The men will wear jeans and top. And the women will be naked. And guess what they'll be doing? And they say that is love. They'll be turning like snakes. Then they'll be doing. I say, what kind of madness is this? When I see it, I fear for my daughter. How can I give birth to a girl? Then all her life, a man will be in jeans and be completely dressed. As for her, she must be naked. Then they call it love. Did Jesus say, all the law is love? Yes, he said that. But what does it mean? Let's read the text. Matthew 22, verse 37 to 38. He says, you shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind. This is the first and the great command. And he continued to say, and the second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two laws or commandments hang all the law and the prophet. What does it mean? Love God, love your neighbor. What does it mean? That is a summary of the Ten Commandments. Law 1 to law 4 is about love for God. If you love God, God will be number 1. If we love him in our lives, if we love God, our worship will be reserved for him alone, not for any Joshua, not for any priest, not for any TK Mensa, not for any Pope, not for any bishop. You will not worship TB Joshua, you will not worship any priest, you will not worship any whoever, including me, you will not. If you love God, will respect his name. You will not claim to be a Christian and you go and take alcohol and you get drunk. If you love God, you will be anxious to keep appointment with him on each Sabbath. Tomorrow I will teach it. So the first 4 laws talk about your relationship, our relationship with God. If that is clear, shout an amen there. Law 5 to law 10, it deals with our relationship with our fellow human beings. So Jesus says, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your mind, with all your soul. This is the first of all the commandments. The second is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself. If you love your neighbor, you know one day you can also keep it. You respect your mother. Because your mother and father is your fellow human being. If you love your neighbor, you will not kill them. You value life. If you love your neighbor, you will preserve morality. You're not going to steal anybody's daughter and mess up with, or anybody's husband and mess up with. If you love your neighbor, you respect their property. You will not steal their property. If you love your neighbor, you be honest in your relationship with each other. When you buy this for 500 naira, you're not going to say it is 1,000 naira. Fiafito. That is in my village language. It means teach. If you love your neighbor, you not covet what belongs to your neighbor. You see some people, they are there. Especially some of the ladies. They will be in church. When their fellow lady is going, they will profile her from top to down. She came late for everybody to shoot her. Yes, shoot. What is this? The law is like a moral bar. We call that guardrails. They put them on the way when there is a valley to prevent accident. Ladies and gentlemen, but the question is, will the law save us? No! The law can never save. The law can never redeem. Ephesians 2 verse 8 and 9. For by grace are we saved through faith. We are saved by what? Grace. not of ourselves. It is the gift of God. My brothers and sisters, salvation is by grace alone. Will you not say amen there? Amen. No law will save you. But if you break the law, you go to hell. The law can never save. But breaking the law will take you to hell. Somebody says, one pastor met me, he says, we are in the dispensation of grace. In the Old Testament, is the dispensation of the law. In the New Testament, is the dispensation of grace. And I say, Pastor, let's get to the Bible. And I open this text for him. Genesis 6, verse 8. Let's read it together. It says what? But Noah found grace in the eyes of who? Was this the Old Testament or the New Testament? How dare you say that in the Old Testament they were saved by law. In the New Testament they are saved by grace. But Noah, he was saved by grace. Without the grace of God, nobody can be saved. That is why the Bible says in Titus 2 verse 11, for the grace of God that brings salvation appeared to only the Igbos, only the Hausas, only the Jews. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to how many men?